Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to discuss a topic, Nazi ideology. Students, Nazi ideology is synonymous to the Hitler ideology because you all know that the leader of the Nazi party, the head of the Nazi party was Hitler. That's why whatever the ideology was of that of Hitler was similar, said to be the ideology of the Nazi party. That's why both the terms, that is Nazi and the Hitler, were used synonymous to one another, the ideology of both. So according to the Nazi ideology or the Hitler ideology, there was no equality in the Nazi Germany. There was inequality among the citizens. All were not treated equally. There was discrimination on the basis of their races. One thing, there was inequality. Another thing, there was a social hierarchy in the society. What is the social hierarchy? Under the social hierarchy, the Nordic Aryan race was considered to be the superior race in the world. And the Jews was considered to be at the lowest strata of the society. Under the social hierarchy, at the top is the Nordic German Aryans, and at the bottom were the Jews. They were so much at the bottom that they were also said to be the anti-race, means they were even not considered to be among one of the race, or they were also said to be the arch enemy. Arch enemy means main enemy of the Aryan race. But anti-race in a similar way as what is social hierarchy? When you understand this in term of, in context of our country India, in India also, in the ancient time, there was a caste hierarchy in the society. Like at the top of the caste, there is a Brahman, then the Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. This is the hierarchy system. One is at the top, then second, third, and at the bottom. And as the way the untouchables, the Dalit, was said to be the outcast people. In a similar way, in the social hierarchy, the Jews were said to be the anti-race. They were even not considered to be one of the race. As in term of the Indian society, the Dalit was said to be the outcast, means not having any caste. Okay. So this racism theory of the Hitler, means this discrimination on the basis of the race, which was there in the mind of the Hitler, which gives shape to the Hitler ideology, as well as you can also say that the Nazi ideology, from where it comes. Now we study this thing. The impact on the mind of the Hitler was of the theories of the books which he had read in his childhood. He had studied about the Charles Darwin as well as about the Herbert Spencer. Now, therefore, we will discuss the theories given by the Charles Darwin and the Herbert Spencer, what they said in their theory and how these theories were taken up, interpreted by the Hitler, and how these theories shaped the Hitler ideology. Okay, so what was said by the Charles Darwin? Who was Charles Darwin? Darwin was the natural scientist, the scientist of the nature, who study about the nature, the plants and the animals. Charles Darwin explained that creation of plants and animals took place through the process of natural selection. Means whenever the evolution of any plant or animal took place, it is done through the natural selection of the genes. Natural selection means, you know the selection, two genes are taken together and from there the new evolution took place of any animal or the plant. But this selection of the gene is natural, according to Darwin. This is important thing in the Darwin theory, that the selection is natural, means it is not made consciously by animal, it is just made by the nature itself, and the concept of the evolution. So this was the theory given by the Charles Darwin. He said that the evolution of the plant and animal took place by the selection process. When any new plant or the animal evolved, it done by the selection of the earlier genes. But that selection is natural. Okay. And now come to the another person, that is the Herbert Spencer. He gave the idea of the survival of the fittest theory. His theory was the survival of the fittest. Means in the world only that creature survive which is said to be the fit according to the environment, according to the nature. According to him, only those species survived. Only those species survive on the earth that could adapt themselves to the changing climatic condition. If any of the species can't be able to adapt themselves according to the changing environmental condition, then that particular creature or the species cannot survive. Like, can take up the example of the dinosaurs also. They can't be able to adapt themselves according to the changing temperature on the earth. That's why they get demolished. So, this theory was given by Herbert Spencer, the survival of the fittest. Now, you will see that both these theories are simple. How they impact the political theory of Hitler. So, now we proceed, then you can understand this thing. We should bear in mind that, that Darwin never advocate the human interference in the natural selection of the gene. As I told you, Darwin said that the selection of the gene is always natural. There should not be any human interference in it. Now we study how this theory impact the mind of the Hitler. However, his idea were used by the racist. Means both these ideas of the Herbert Spencer, that the survival of the fittest idea, as well as the Charles Darwin idea of the selection. These ideas were used by the racist thinker. Racist thinkers, who are the racist thinkers? The thinkers, the people who think on the basis of the race. Means, who said that this particular race is superior and another one is inferior. Okay, they are said to be the racist person. Like some said that black people are inferior, white are superior. Those people are said to be the racist person. So now we proceed. His ideas were used by racist thinkers and the politicians. And they were used to justify their imperial rule over the conquered people. But you all know that during the time of the colonialism period, the period when the India was the colony under the Britishers, in the similar way, other nations were also the colony under the different European powers like Britain, French, Dutch. These were the European power who made rest of the world their colony. So this theory was used by this imperial power to justify their rule over the colony. Because these people said that these colonized people are the uncivilized one. They are inferior in race, and we are superior. That's why it's our duty to civilize these uncivilized people, this uncivilized race. So this thing is said here to justify imperial rule, to justify their rule over the colony. Like, when Britishers rule over the Indians, they said Indians to be the inferior and the barbaric race. And what theory they had given, they said that it is our duty, it is our responsibility, because we are civilized one, that's why it is our responsibility to civilize these uncivilized people. So this thing is said over here, the imperial rulers justify their rule over the colony through these theories of the Charles Darwin and the Herbert Spencer. And Nazi also argued that, Nazi means Nazi party or the Hitler, argued that what was their theories, now we understand. Okay, till now beta we studied that the background of the Hitler ideology, from where the ideology of the Hitler was formed. Now we come mainly to the points of the Hitler ideology. He said that strongest race survive and weak one would perish. According to Hitler, only the strongest one has the right to live on the earth. Means the same Herbert Spencer, survival of the fittest. So Hitler also said that strongest race survive and the weaker one would have to be perished, would have to be finished. Second thing said by the Nazi, according to the Nazi ideology or said by the Hitler was that Aryan race was the fittest one. पहले क्या firstly they said that the Nazi race is the superior one. Firstly they said that the strongest race should survive only. Then in the second point they said that the Aryan race is the fittest one, is the strongest one, and therefore had to retain its purity, became dominate and rule the world. They said that the Aryan race, the Nordic Aryan people, what are their physical characteristics? They are fair in complexion, having brown hairs and blue eyes, tall heighted, sharp features. These are the features of the Nordic Aryan race, Nordic German Aryans people. And according to Hitler, this is the fittest race on the earth. And that's why he said that the according to the Herbert Spencer theory, the only the fittest race should survive and dominate the world and rule the world. Because it is the fittest one, it is the strongest one, that's why it is only having the right to rule over the people. And it is also responsibility, also the responsibility of the race as well as of the Hitler Nazi party to retain the purity of the Nordic German Aryan race. That under their leadership, they don't allow anyone to make this race impure. How the race became impure? When any Aryan person get married to non-Aryan, obviously then the gene of both get mixed up, and the result, the evolved child will be the of the mixed race. So here what they said, they used the Charles Darwin theory and said that selection process, but here the selection more remain natural. There is the human interference. The Nazi party people, the Hitler, don't allow any Aryan. Later on you will study this. They will not allow any Aryan to marry to any non-Aryan. So beta, these two things. Now we come to the topic Lebensraum. What is there in the Lebensraum? This is also one of the ideology of the Nazi party or the Hitler. According to Lebensraum, the meaning of this is, Lebensraum is the geographical concept of the living space. According to this, the Nazi party said that the Aryan race, the Nordic Aryan race, need a more territory to live. So that when we conquer the more land, then obviously we have a more living space for the Aryan race as well as the more natural resources for them. So what is Lebensraum? It is the geographical concept of the living space. Hitler believed that new territories had to be acquired. New territories had to be conquered, had to be acquired. Why? To increase the area of the mother country. Here the mother country is the Germany. To increase the area of the Germany for the settlers, for the Aryan race. And this would also enhance by the conquering the new area, by adding the new area, the material resources of Germany also get increased. And this thing increased the power of the German nation. So Hitler intended to extend German boundary eastward. So beta, when I explain you regarding the map, you have seen that here is France, and when they move to eastward, there is a Russia. There is Poland. They occupied Poland, then moved to Russia, occupied some of the region of the northwestern Russia. But later on, the Russian army stopped them, and then the Second World War started. This thing you know, we discussed in the previous video. Okay, so for extending the area, territorial area, Hitler started to be moving towards the eastward to the Russian territory. And all these things, when Germany conquered the region of Poland, then they made the Poland their laboratory. Laboratory of the experiment. Why it is said to be the laboratory of the experiment? Later on, beta, in the next video, you will study that at Poland, they made their concentration camps. as well as the get gas chamber where the unwanted race were killed, like the Jews people were killed over there. So it is said to be, this is the technical terminology used by the Nazi party, like the Lebensraum, laboratory is the terminology used by the Nazi party for the place of the killing of the unwanted races, like that of the Jews. So that's why they said it to be the laboratory. Okay, and experiment means they are experiment by eliminating any one particular race. Okay, so regarding the terminology used by them, you will study in the next video. Thank you all.